making up their own words right now about like they're like using Hanskin's name for, I don't know. They do these weird things when they have like their own language almost in BMG. Yeah, they're, so
It's
they have a lot
it's
of.
called Swedish.
Outside of that, they have
Ah.
this BMG language that only they understand.
Gotcha.
So they're probably fooling around a lot and having a lot of fun. And considering that Reason Gaming are playing with two ringers, I do believe. I don't recognize the dark green guy.
Yeah. Ping
And
Vincek,
yeah, not really sure who that is. I mean, it's gonna be rough. But I think if they stick to what they do best, if they run stuff like Nymphora, stick to that, run the Tundra maybe even, that's their comfort zone. Stick to what they do best, it
yeah.
might still work out.
We'll see. We'll see. They're best. Going to start with Rhapsody here with their first pick. Parasite, the overall first pick, of course. And obviously, you look at that. He was open last game, banned this game. But how about those bans? Pharaoh and Engineer taken out by BMG. Ophelia and then Puppet Master taken out by Reason Gaming. So only the one jungler being banned here. Thus, why we see Parasite first pick. And possible to see a Tempest maybe? Or is that not
I don't
Reason?
think so. I was actually quite surprised last game that Hanskin decided to ban two out of the three jungle heroes that were banned, I do believe. Actually,
Yeah.
no. He only banned one.
Definitely,
But still, I mean, Reason Gaming really know not to play junglers. They don't like to play jungle heroes, and they don't touch Ophelia. I don't think I've ever seen them play Ophelia. If they do jungle, it's Tempest or Parasite. So, I was really surprised to see that last game. But yeah, now he thought a little bit about it, remembered, oh, well, right, I'm playing Reason. Why am I banning junglers? Decided not to do that, bans out active heroes. Like, Pharaoh, definitely one of Reason Gaming's most comfortable heroes. Engineer, I'm not so sure, but then again, Engineer is a great laner. And as I said last game, Reason Gaming just want to win those lanes. That is their number one priority, win
Yeah.
our lanes. And I think that's why they went for the Parasite first pick. Parasite kind of does not allow for that to happen. He's such a big impact during the laning phase, such an active hero, can do so much. Very, very hard to control early on if you don't get the right wards. So, yeah, there we go. Nymphora picked by Reason. I like this a lot.
There you go. It's almost as if they're either listening in, or again, this is just what they're knowing we're doing. So kind of that comfort factor, if anything, as you've been stressing here since the first game, even. So yeah, they will go the Nymphora Pebbles Rhapsody here. So yeah, no jungler going to be had here on their side, most likely. Back over to BMG, the Torture again, the Hag, speaking of comfort, Wretched Hag, very very potent hero of theirs in general too for many of teams, of course. But really know it for the Hag, either Fousey or Jonas, a fan could end up with that. It's just a matter of where it fits best. But Master of Arms Vindicator coming out as the bans for BMG so far. Gauntlet Ravener from Reason. So obviously they're focusing on that super KG effect right here. And
Yeah.
taking his heroes.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, Kronos is still on the board. I think that hero on the Legion side would be absolutely devastating to face for Reason. Just such nice synergy with pretty much everything they have. Parasite will really just get them through the laning phase, make sure they get that farm. Torture and Hag together with the Kronos, so scary to face.
Yeah.
And Pestilence is still open as well. And I know this is something that Reason Gaming likes to do quite a lot, where they give the other team Pestilence and then they would like to run a dual lane middle to face it. Preferably with Master of Arms or Torture, but both those heroes are out of like they can't really pick either of them, so it'll be interesting to see what they do. But I
Yeah.
think Kronos definitely top tier pick here for BMG.
All right, so yeah, well, you see the right click on it right there, and at least similar thinking definitely coming out. But it's also a matter too, again, if BMG maybe wants to try a little bit of something different here. As obviously, sure, there is something on the line. It is very minimal in the end as far as the prize pool. And actually, speaking of the format, again, I saw people talking about that in chat. So real quickly, how the format works with King of the Hill. So you have the challenger fight the initial Tuesdays, such as today, as Magma's picked up. Then on Thursdays, how it usually goes, it will be the title fight. Currently, Stay Green, they're the titles. They defeated Sync Esports last week, knocking them off the throne and regaining it. So they get their portion of the prize pool for taking it last week. But then every single week, you stay in that king spot, meaning if say Stigma was to beat whoever they face here on Thursday, the prize that they would get for now this week would actually be increased by a certain amount, and every single week it increases. I believe, and it can happen a max of 5 times, I believe, or something like that before it's eventually all knocked off. But so again, the further win streak you go, the more you get out of it in that sense. So just to kind of clarify how the format actually works here. But again, they go the Magmas route, so BMG. Doing the Magmas here in this series for Super KG.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I think this is very typical snowball teams. They find a hero, it works out great, they stick to it. And I'm not really, I think that's fine. If it's working for them, then why change, what is it you say? Why change a working?
What fix what ain't broken? Why fix
Exactly.
what ain't
Thank you.
broken? There
Thank you.
you
Yeah,
go.
that's what I was thinking about. I'm actually, I was just thought hit me. Sir Benzington is a hero that I've been like thinking this guy is gonna be all over Thailand. And against this weak zoning hero like Nymphora,
Yeah.
Benzington is absolutely crazy.
Huh.
He is so hard to shut down. I think I'd say he's one of the best suicides if it comes to like just getting experience against dual lanes.
Yeah.
So yeah, I mean, I think he still fits their lineup really well. Very, very nice global presence. A lot of early game damage. The only problem would be that they kind of lack that late game presence and the real kind of initiation that they might need. Magnus and Hag both more up towards you'd rather have another initiator for them to be really, really impactful to get that triple stun from the mag with the ultimate lined up, rather than to force them to initiate. So yeah, they go with the Devo. They go with another initiator. I think that's fine. Personally, I would have loved to see the Kronos. I think that would have synergized perfectly with their lineup, but
Yeah.
I know they like to run the Devo against Pebbles Middle. That's how the whole trend started, I do believe, as well.
Is it? Wow.
I think so, yeah.
Pebbles has always been a hero of trademark on the competitive scene, so yeah, it wouldn't be too surprising.
Yeah.
But yeah, so with that Teemo pick, though, so that means, yeah, Magma's going to be more that suicide hero in this case, played by Jonas Fehm, most likely, is what it comes down to. So, and you know, whenever there's a Parasite, the idea of a possibly kind of a pseudo tri-lane is definitely there, but we'll see. Warbeast is the final pick, by the way, over
Yeah.
there for a reason. They went the Dr. Upholstery as well. I don't even know if we really touched up on that. Imboboy going to end up playing that Dr. Upholstery here. So, how do you think Reason Gaming fared in the end?
Yeah, I mean, this is a very, very Reason lineup. This is exactly the kind of lineup that I would like to see them play. If this was their main roster playing, I would say, yes, this is what you guys need to play. A lot of heroes that can control the map very much. Like, Warbeast got the Wolves. He's got high mobility, can be pretty much anywhere on the map. Can farm very, very aggressively. You got the Nymphora and the Doctor who can TP in together. You got the Nymphora that synergizes with the Pebbles perfectly. And then the Rhapsody who's just always a great hero. So much gank presence from this Hellborn team, and they're really, really strong in lanes as well because of the Warbeast battle cry, which hopefully will make up for the Nymphora being kind of weak in lane up top. So a really smart draft on their end. I really, really like it. But it's the problem is that they're running a no jungle against the jungle strategy where I don't feel like they have the advantage in all of the lanes where they need them. Middle lane, the Devo, or actually, is he going top?
Oh, it's being
Yeah,
played
they
by
swapped
Jonathan
Jonas
Fan.
is playing
Wow.
Devo, yeah.
That's something you would never expect, especially from BMG. Wow. Okay.
That is really interesting. Actually, that kind of changes things.
Yeah, I definitely would say so.
Yeah, because now it's not the dual lane, Pebbles dual lane mid against the Devo. Okay. I don't know. That's actually really interesting because I think. I don't know. Are they going long lane with this? What is? I have
Yeah.
no idea what they're doing.
I mean, you got Reason Gaming down here, obviously scouting out with the Wolves, of course, and getting some good information. They're going to block some camps here, most likely. Nothing placed just yet so far, but Rhapsody does have one Rev and one Ward Aside on her.
Yeah, it takes a lot of balls to ward camps against Handskin, though. This
Yeah.
guy is so good at finding those wards. I don't know how he does it. He has
Yeah.
some sixth sense for finding wards in his camps.
It's pretty ridiculous. It's like,
Yeah.
yeah, no, trust me, we notice that a lot here
Yeah.
from our perspective. It's like, oh, the good blocks. It's like, oh, never mind. Hanska just countered both the wards that you placed in that one camp. Yeah, it's pretty ridiculous. So he is gonna have to deal with that here. Speaking of that, I mean, they double block that middle camp, and then as well as the left hard camp over there. So is
Yeah.
he? He's gonna be going other jungle though, it looks like.
It does look like it. I wonder if Dr. Pulsar's magnetic contraptions actually block camps. That could be kind of an interesting mechanic if it does. He could just place one there and run away. But no, it does look like that pseudo
Huh.
tri-lane, and I don't think Reason Gaming. They do seem to be aware that Parasite's going to be in their jungle, or at least they're preparing themselves for it by blocking the two camps at the start of the game.
Yeah.
If Handskin isn't patient enough, he might mistake this for. That they warded all of the starting camps for him. Because this is something that you can do. You can buy the two counter wards and two normal wards and do that. Oh, here we go. He's in a lot of trouble
Yeah, and
now.
he doesn't have a creep to take over. He's gonna realize that. He's like, crap, I can't invest. He did sidestep right there on the back end of the Zeal Stun, though. That was beautiful. And he is gonna be fine in the end as he takes over a Minotaur. So yeah, that was definitely scary, but Hanskin making the big plays and he is gonna be fine in the end, so.
Yeah. He takes over the Minotaur, runs away, and just denies it instantly. He sees now that he has a camp. And, I mean, his farm is going to be really, really slow, but unfortunately for St. Roxy, doesn't have a camp either to really work with for the pull. But here we go. They're going to go for a kill attempt up at the top lane. Torture is hiding in the trees. He has a stun instead of impalement, which is quite surprising.
Yeah, he's going to use it right there
for
on an Amphora. He
Oh,
missed the other
no.
one, though, but now Torture might be in some trouble. Can they turn this, perhaps? No, they're not even going to go for it just yet. Devourer's still here. He has the Decay up. He's going to activate it right here on top of Rhapsody. Rhapsody dropping. Rhapsody's going to fall. Bloodless go in favor of BMG, and it might be a second one as well. Amphora's also going to get caught, and that'll definitely be a second kill. Hanskin picking up both kills right there in his favor, and now he's back to farming. And Devourer does have a hook now. If he can maybe get Dr. Po- oh, no, you know what's coming. You know what's coming. You can just feel, maybe not. Maybe not.
They have no vision here, though.
Okay,
there are no creeps to spot out the doctor. Yeah, no, that was actually really, really important. I'm not really sure what Reason was doing there. They had a for sure kill on the Torture there.
Yeah.
Torture popped the stun, only hit the Amphora. Rhapsody completely tunnel visioning onto the Devourer there, ignoring the fact that he could have just turned around and went for the Tort, and now they're in a horrible position.
You go. The hook in right there. Dr. Impulsor is doing his part. He's not level 6 yet, of course, so no ludicrous speed coming on, and especially without that ability, he doesn't really stand much of a chance in terms of getting away. So talk about a snowball effect right off the bat here by Bad Monkey Gaming. I mean, they are making the best of it initially. And again, it looked like, I mean, there was a chance there for Reason to get the initial kill even on the Parasite and kind of set the tone themselves, but it backfired, it didn't work out, and we're kind of seeing that result now play out here as things are picking up. Perhaps they need to get the haste rune, but I'm on cost right here. Stunt runs right into Magnus, and he will fall as well. Panty goes down, Super KG cutting him off. He was kind of toying with him with that haste rune, and Super KG's like, if you're going to do that, you know what, I'm just going to come out finish you off right there. And that he did. Well, ugly start for Reason Gaming so far, unfortunately.
Yeah, and I mean, this is just disastrous for them. They set up their lanes to win the lanes. That's really, like, if they don't do that, it's going to hurt them really hard. They warded up pretty much all of Parasite's camps to make sure that he does not get a good start. But guess what? Sitting at 440 GPM, got him a lot of kills, and he's doing just fine. Even if he suffers for the next couple of minutes, he's going to do... He's got him the items that he needs. He's got those boots. Devourer also has those boots already. He's going to be so hard to zone and kill out here at top.
I mean, you see right here, they're going to attempt it. He has got a couple of those gauntlets as well, so he's tanked up. Parasite running in. Parasite going to go for the turn kill. Yeah, he's going to try to hook him, but good job by Dr. Pulsar standing in front. And Anskin's going to fall right there. So a little bit of decision making. That wasn't the brightest in the end, as again, they were looking for the hook, but it was a good job by Dr. Pulsar standing in front and making sure that he couldn't hook him. So a little bit of extra confidence boost there for PMG may have backfired in the end, so that's good news for Reason.
Definitely. Reason Gaming needed that. Now Parasite is forced out of your jungle. This is a much bigger deal than it might actually just look like. It's so much more than just a kill. Parasite is one of those heroes that, if he gets a good start, huge impact. He has that. He has pretty much what he needs. But instead of being this massive hero that he had the potential to be with a 2-0-2 situation that he was going with, the one kill is really going to slow him down. It's going to put him back in his own jungle with a camp. One of his camps is still warded.
Yeah.
And it's going to shut him down a lot. There's a ward down bottom for Zane that's going to show movement as well. So Hansen's probably going to be forced to farm quite a lot now. And a little bit of a miss on his window opportunity there.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah. I mean, you see a PMG right here. The Devourer, he was rotating. He actually tried to help mid initially, but the hook missed. It didn't really matter. He's got a bottom now delivered. And he's kind of making his way all the way to the bottom lane, basically. He's going to finish off that Wild Hunter that come down here. So are they actually planning on having Fousey move? Or you talked about this ward of sight here from Zane, too. It's going to spot Devourer coming over, and immediately Warbeast heads right back. So I'm sure Jonathan Mann may pick up on that, but by the time they get a Rev Ward out here, it's going to already be gone anyway. So not the biggest deal in the world if they look to address that.
It's not for certain that they actually do think about that. They know that a lot of camps are warded this game, so they're probably assuming that Reason Gaming used all of their wards to block camps.
Okay.
And when you make an assumption like that, you're just going to play as if they had no vision anywhere else on the map.
Oh, yeah, middle lane. Rhapsody already getting picked off. They're going for a second, but the hook will connect right there. And as a result, Pebbles will most likely fall. Yes, he will. Jonas Vivian porting in and helping to set up that sequence. Missed the initial part of that, but obviously coming together there for BMG. It looks like Parasite came in with a Vagabond leader as well for the assistant. So the movement continues from BMG, and their lead will grow as a result. You see the Infamous Magma, Super KG, he's looking for an opportunity. I don't know if he's going to be able to find it, though, in the meantime. So But BMG is going back to their tactics of just moving around, being very aggressive. And again, look at Jonas Ben. He's now all the way back to the top lane. So he walked all the way to the bottom lane. He ended up porting mid to set up some counter kills. And now he's back at the top lane. Say the least, he's just being mobile here on good old Devour.
I mean, he's doing what the team needs him to do. He's finding kills. He's finding opportunities. He's not letting them get away. Here we go. Bottom dive. Going to get the kill on Zane. So really nice patience from Super KG. Finally going to get that stun.
Yeah.
That's the kill secured. And, I mean, Fousey's going to get really, really big. And the hag that snowballs is just so hard to deal with. But, I mean, the good news is, for reason, they do have the heroes if they are able to get the levels. Nymphora needs to get that level 6. They need a much slower game pace than what they got running right now because they just don't have the means to deal with this early high pressure from BMG.
Yeah. Poor coming into the bottom lane. That is Warbeast, of course, just getting back here after that death and going to look to push back out Wretched Hag. But, again, Hag's looking very strong here. 371 gold per minute. Start for her. Happens to be the top of the game currently. But actually, Dr. Pulse are going to be coming in right here. Can she blink away in time? Yes, she can. Will it be enough? One more auto attack. Going to be enough for the kill. The ultimate form from Warbeast taking care of business. And Wretched Hag will be picked off in the end. So, again, Reason Gaming doing enough there to at least slow things down a little bit. But now, as I mentioned that, the middle lane, we do have some more action picking up. Parasite's chasing. He's not level 6 just yet. He throws out the leech. The hook going to miss right there from Jonas the Fan. But now they're going to collapse on a Rhapsody. Here comes the lock by Sam from Bebelzol. The beautiful Zeus on the top. Rhapsody will end up falling. Now Bebelzol's going to be locked down by the Nom 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 right there from Devour. And Bebelzol is going to end up falling in the process. Devour's going to look for another hook attempt right here. He's got the haste here. And it looks like Nymphora's in a lot of trouble. There's the hook. The easy land. And Nymphora is going to be picked off when it's all said and done. So, again, it's a little bit of hope there for Reason Gaming, and then it just all falls apart, and BMG picks up 3 kills straight.
Yeah, the high-paced game is just not... Reason Gaming just not dealing with this well, and I think this has a lot to do with them having 2 ringers, to be honest. When you're not your own team, the communication is normally very, very off,
yeah.
And when you're playing as a team that's running so aggressively, they're just pushing on you, they're just constantly in your face doing things, it's so hard to deal with it if your communication is not on top.
Yeah. We're definitely seeing that is a fair point. Again, you're already dealing against a team like BMG who's prepping for these world finals where so much is on the line, of course, and we just even saw that first game, just how on fire and on the ball they look, and you have a team yourselves where you're not even your main 5 in the process. It no doubt is going to hurt. So they're giving it their best effort, but BMG just seems like they're the superior team today for obvious reasons, and we'll see if they can just keep that up and how long Reason Gaming is going to be able to put up a fight here and maybe try to get that turnaround in here somewhere. But the bottom lane is more interesting action. Wretched Hag is going to be gone once again, but they were ready for this the whole time. Devour comes, and they will kill Wretched Hag still, but it ends up being a 1-for-1 in the end. So Hag still gets locked down to the point of death at least. So feeling a little bit good, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, this is honestly not too bad for Reason Gaming. They're finding kills. They're finding kills on the right heroes. I mean, Fousey is really going to be the one that's going to snowball out of control if anyone does, but oh, yeah. Middle lane.
Yes. Getting distracted there for a second, but Pebbles is going to be turned around on now. Yep, he's going to end up falling. Double tap for Seal Kid, and it looks like Hans going to want some more. And he might get it, actually. Nymphora trying to get away. Does have his heal stun coming up in 1 second. In comes Dr. Pulsar. Hanskin going a little bit too deep, but actually a stun from Magnus right there. But no, Hanskin isn't going to end up flying. Maybe, yeah, when the leech goes off, he got the kill. But he dies right after that in the process. So Magnus and Torch are going to hold their ground in the meantime. And Magnus stunning in. Super KGE. He wants to go balls to the wall. Oh, the chain reaction just a little bit too late. The staccato stun stunned the initial attempt. The hook connects up from Jonas the Fan. Down goes Dr. Pulsar. And now the ultimate from Devour. But no, he cancels it immediately as soon as he saw that TP coming. And Dr. Pulsar with a buyback. And he gets revenge. What is going on this game all of a sudden? Rhapsody's now in some trouble. She'll end up falling. But at what cost here? Wretched Hag going to be pulled in. Wretched Hag will fall. And now Torture might be in some trouble as well. Yes, the Zeal Stunt connects. And Torture is going to be picked off. I don't know. I mean, so Doctor used to buy back. But okay.
Devour
and actually,
Jonas
the Fan comes back. And yeah, that happens. And I think it's finally over.
Yeah, I mean, that was a lot of action going on. And I don't know, Fousey's dying a lot. He's only sitting at 300 GPM. He's not really doing too well. And, I mean, the game is definitely heavily in BMG's favor, and it's very, very unlikely that they lose. But you got 2 carries on the side of Reason that are both doing better than the carries on BMG. The carry on BMG.
That is very true. And I, Magnus was a very, very hopeful there with that attempt as he stunned in and tried to channel the eruption right with Rhapsody in the background. Either he just saw that too later. He's kind of hoping that Rhapsody was AFK for a little bit. But in the end, Panty was aware and able to stop him. And the chuck away also obviously doing work. So the missed gank attempt. And you look at the experience chart as well. It's both Warbeast and Dr. Repulsor especially are up there. Tops right now in the game as far as experience is concerned. So, you know, this is the one, I guess, few downsides of the strat from BMG is they stick together and the experience tends to be not as high individually as the other team in certain cases. But as you were saying, though, I mean, big picture, no doubt, BMG is still in a comfortable spot. But, yeah, the carry potential is there for Reason Gaming. And by all means, if BMG especially continues to make some very aggressive moves that could backfire, then Reason Gaming could have that chance of eventually climbing back into it, but we'll have to wait and see how obviously that turns out. Bottom lane is pushed in. Zane able to push it in. He also had the assistance of Dr. Repulsor down there. All right, so I mean, kind of come with the, where do you think Dr. Repulsor should go with his item build? That icon of the goddess here?
It's very, I think Dr. Repulsor is one of those heroes where you have a lot of options, and it really, really is individual, up to the players. Like, what do you prefer? What style do you like to play him as?
Yeah.
I think the Hellflower of this game is absolutely amazing if he's able to get it. But then again, he's going to be so squishy to all of that magic damage. And I think he's going to have to buy a BKB eventually, but bottom lane.
Yeah, oh my god, the turnaround right there. Holy crap. That was a jump on a Warbeast, and Dr. Repulsor Warbeast turn it on a Wretched Hag. And now Dr. Repulsor going to go for the TP out. He should be fine. No, he had to dodge the hook, actually. So he's now in a lot of trouble here. You see the Hellhounds are still here as well. But Dr. Repulsor out of mana. He does have a bottle charge on him. He's going to use it right here. Hope for the best. It's just not going to be enough, though. He is eventually going to be picked off. And down goes Imba Boy. So the roaming of BMG. If Doctor was able to survive, of course, that would have worked out beautifully for Reason Gaming. But the fact that they got him picked off, pretty big deal. But and then there's Warbeast, though. Again, he's now finishing Abyssal Skull. He's actually looking very solid on that GPM chart. 370 gold per minute here.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's a little bit of a shame there that Imba Boy just didn't trust his brother enough to, for the brother black the wolves with a hook, to just stay there with the TP, but decided to move away, and that for sure guaranteed the death on him. Mm-hmm. So, but yeah, wasted a lot of time for BMG, and as you said, yeah, they're getting farm on Warbeast, but I think more importantly, Nymphora's getting some levels and Pebbles as well. I would love to see the supports on the Hellborn team just stack the jungle like crazy now. Make sure they get that Pebbles blink before the 20-minute mark at least. I mean, his farm isn't looking that bad. I mean, he's not too far off. So, Imba Boy really doing a great job of using the early farm he was given this time, as opposed to last time when he was a Vindicator, not able to really do much with it. Mm-hmm. This time with Dr. Repulsor, he's moving around the map, securing farm for his teammates, making sure that XPM goes up much, much higher than it was before.
Yeah. Good. All right, here he's got an Invisor and he has Strider's activated. Yeah, they know. The Rev Ward's down. Okay, so they kind of see him poking right here. They don't want to go unless they are absolutely certain. Look at Jonas Van, man. Those spider senses tingling. He just knows something is up, and in the end, he is going to be fine as far as that's concerned. Oh, God, it's close, though. Okay, he's going back in. Oh, okay. Can they capitalize? They know he's here, obviously. It's so awkward, though. They know that there's support also nearby, so... Yeah, they're not going to collapse. Instead, they're just going to run away. And I think they should be fine in the end. I mean, Pebbles, he would be the one target that maybe might be in some trouble, actually. Oh, Devourer coming in. Can he land the hook? Yes, he can. And now Pebbles going to be pulled in. Puts the slagmites out. Here comes Dr. Repulsor. The big line's down from Magnus coming out, though. Pebbles will end up falling. Dr. Repulsor goes down. And now Rhapsody's going to be picked off on top of it all. Maybe, yes, she will go down. The seal's different in 4-0. He's trying to TP out. He will be successful. But a lot of damage done right there. In the end, Warbeast is going to port out before he gets caught pushing out the bottom lane. So, again, though, big picture, BMG, 3 kills in sequence, working a Portakey on Magnus obviously helps with that. And they also delay the Portakey on Pebbles that much more. And, again, the levels on Nymphora, still only level 4. Really need that level 6 in the Portakey combination. But it's just not happening at this pace in this game right now for a reason.
No, I mean, this is what I was talking about during the drafting phase, how you would like to have another initiator except for your Magnus, so that the Magnus can wait and counter-initiate and get those huge, beautiful stuns. Right there, he caught both the Dr. Repulsor and the support hero that was in there. I'm not really sure exactly who it was, if it wasn't for Rhapsody, but...
Yeah, I think it was Rhapsody, but yeah.
Okay, yeah. So it's just really, really important that when you run a hero like Magnus, who just has such fantastic counter-initiation potential. Same with Behemoth, same with Kronos. You just need to have another initiator as well. It just makes those heroes so much stronger than if they are forced to initiate themselves.
Yeah. What was I going to say? Oh, yeah, the item build here on Jonas a fan. Again, you're not usually playing the Devourer. What are you making of the Astrolabe, the Striders?
I mean, team items are always amazing. The Striders, I can't really speak too much of, but he was running around map a lot. He was going between top and bottom. And when you're rotating that much, it kind of pays off. The items work out great. He got kills with them, and they really did fill their role. So I don't think you can complain too much about it. And the Astrolabe is amazing in teamfights. It kind of makes the Devourer have more value than what he normally would, because a Devourer really doesn't do that much except for the hook that he throws out in the fight. The Vought pretty much kills himself to do damage to you. So you don't really normally focus a Devo at all, but having that Astrolabe, he kind of becomes like, oh shit, this guy can do more than what he normally would be able to do. So makes him a little bit of a higher priority target, provides more protection for the Hag and the Magmus to really do a lot of damage in the team fights. So I like the pickup.
Yeah, picks up a life tube here, so probably, you know, eventually that Shaman Cedrus and doing a full barrier idol. Speaking of just good team support items coming
out.
Yeah, bottom lane eruption going to be going off right there. Dr. Pulsar being locked with the face hug on top, and Dr. Pulsar could not even blink before he got picked off. We do see Rhapsody now in a lot of trouble as well. Rhapsody will be able to port out and is going to be fine. Top lane, though, in the meantime, we got BMG able to push in that tower. 11,000 gold lead, 8,500 experience lead now coming out in their favor, as now you see Nymphora and Pebbles again. Nymphora is still level 5. She's so close to level 6, but still not able to hit the mark just yet. And 1530 gold on Pebbles, but they're actually going to find Turtle. No, he missed his stalagmite, so that could come back to bite him in the ass right here. However, the Zealous Titan will hit both. The Disco Inferno put down, and Torture is picked off in the end. So the numbers just weren't there for BMG to capitalize off the mistake, but now they got numbers. Devourer running in. The random hook is going for the fences. But that one misses right there. So, again, it's a case of Recent Gaming doing maybe enough to kind of keep things in here and keep things interesting. And, again, Warbeast is scary. Hell, he gets a shrunken head, and he's already showing that. He can do a lot of damage quickly. So, what was that? Legion Courier gets picked off. Speaking of Warbeast and his good old Hellhounds. But I think it's safe to say Zane's going to be that saving grace. And once they finally get that portal key, because they do have a level 6 and 4 now, Is that still going to be impactful, do you think?
I mean, it's always scary to play against a Nymphora with a Pebbles with Nymphora.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if it's a 30-minute level 6 Nymphora or when it is. Once she gets that, beautiful stun.
Yeah, that was big right there. Pebbles going to follow it up. Wretchedat going to be locked down and eventually killed. Hellhound taken over by Parasite, though. And now the chase is happening from Hanskin. Disco or Rhapsody with the Protective Melody. Not enough, though. We got stunned. Down goes Dr. Pulsar. Rhapsody's going to be picked off. And now you see actually the chase is on, but no, TP out of whoever that was. I think it was Nymphora. Going to be fine. So again, BMG just coming out on top here as far as that fight was concerned. But 19 minutes in, we do got BMG just doing enough and now moving together as a team. But again, so the portal key. They got the portal key in Sania. Is this where it all turns around?
I mean, this they have the opportunity to do it now. But looking at BMG, it's really important, though, that every single hero except for Magmus has vestments. Actually, Parasite doesn't either. That's kind of bad.
Yeah.
But they're really, really tanky. They're not going to be one shot by the Pebbles. They need to have the Dr. Pulsar find an opportunity to jump and have the Nymphora Pebbles TP in to the side or next to them.
Yeah.
They need the three heroes to get the kills now. But it's still definitely very possible, and it's going to be scary for the Hag to farm lanes. And Hag really, it's a hero that she can farm so fast if she has the space to do so. And it really, really is going to prevent her from doing that. And Fousey isn't really having the greatest of games. He's not finding those,
I mean, that was just Dr. Pulsar flying in, and they followed it up. I mean, Pebbles was able to get there with the portal key, of course. And they just caught Magmus kind of lingering behind, trying to flee that whole time. So, yeah, I think I mean, you bring up a good point about Fousey especially. He's continues to not have the brightest game here as that carry potential hero here for BMG. So,
yeah,
that's kind of a chance.
I feel like normally he's the kind of player that he always knows where his window is, where he needs to be. He knows when he can jump into the fight, and normally doesn't die much. But this game, he's just been dying so much and not really finding any flow in his farming or anything like that in his gameplay at all. Just needs to focus up and find that window and just really focus on his gameplay and trying not to die anymore in this game.
Yeah. So we got Devourer cleaning out his own jungle here, of course. You can tell Recent Gaming as far as their map positioning. They got a ward to side around the Kongor pit, but other than that, it's pretty dark here on their side, it's safe to say. On the other hand, you got BMG, some pretty aggressive wards coming out from them, including a couple in that Hellborn jungle. So obviously a lot of that has to do just with the momentum and the pace of this game right now. Now it just continues to be in favor of BMG. But there you go. Panda able to get in position to place this ward of sight down here at the bottom side. But uh-oh, the puzzle box minions. Okay, never mind. Thought they were going to spot it right there. Okay, they go back. Yeah. So they know it's there. There you go. That's unfortunate. As he just
the low-level puzzle box minions have very, very
small radius,
little
yeah.
vision. Yeah, exactly. So it's kind of hard to find the wards until you get that level 2 or 3 puzzle box. So I wouldn't have been too surprised if you missed that ward. But good news for Reason Gaming. We got BKB starting to come really close to Zane.
Yeah.
And he's basically going to be invulnerable when he has that running. The only real damage that they have that goes through BKB is the impalement from Torture. And with all the creeps and minions and everything that's going to be around him, it's probably not going to have the biggest of impacts.
Yeah. Yeah, this is definitely a good chance here, say the least, from Reason Gaming, as far as them getting that Shrunken Head pick up, and then who knows where they can go. But it still doesn't happen, and you do see, obviously, the push coming out from PMG. That secondary tower is going to be finished. And right now, that means the bottom secondary will be the only outer tower left in favor of Reason Gaming for them to have to on their side to defend with. But actually, there's a good job split pushing here by Reason at the same time. They're gonna force BMG to make a decision, and that's to kind of defend both these towers. Hanskin will deny that bottom tower, and Devour is going to protect the top tower enough to keep it out of deny range by any means, and going to be able to keep it alive for now. So solid defense at the same time from BMG. And it looks like they might actually just reset some things here and kind of head back towards the middle, if anything. I mean, they're waiting. Magma's very patiently is waiting for that opportunity. They got a ward of sight in the lane. They just bought a Shrunken Head on Warbeast, though, so there you go. He's going to have it delivered right here. Probably going to be seen, but is Magma's going to try for something?
I don't think so.
Yeah, he's
buying himself. the strategy here, if you're BMG, is very, very, I think it might be difficult. You need to find these hero kills on the important targets now. They're starting to get items. For a while, there was a lot of action going on, a lot of deaths happening from both sides, but BMG was the only team that was getting kills. They were the only team, the only team that was getting items. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of the other way around. BMG's gotten really slowed down, and we see, Reason Gaming being the team that are picking up items and getting what they need.
Yeah.
So you're in a pretty difficult position here strategically if you're BMG. You want to farm the Hag, but at the same time, you got to start preventing the other team from finishing up their items. If they get that Hellflower, maybe even the BKB on Dr. Repulsor, mm-hmm. he is going to be so dangerous to deal with. The Puzzle Box is suddenly not going to be burning all of his mana, and he's going to be having a huge impact in these fights. I would almost like to see him go BKB right now.
Yeah.
Don't even finish that Hellflower.
Oh, Magmus actually knew he was here and saying that is, and now here comes Preston with the follow-up. Warbeast, though, he should be fine. Yeah, he's going to have Shrunken Head, so they at least force that cooldown. But Warbeast knows that he is more than fine. He didn't use his ulti form, at least. So he will still have that up for another opportunity. Granted, it was only a 60-second cooldown in the first place, but meanwhile, the top lane now, yeah, again, you can really just feel it. BMG, the momentum, the movement here has definitely slowed down, and that is no doubt to the favor of Reason Gaming, but it's at the same time, it's like the stats have continued to rise, though, in favor of PMG for both the gold and experience. So
yeah.
That's where it's constantly you're looking at that like, okay, well, PMG's still, again, in that very, very good and comfortable spot. But the one or two, one specifically in Warbeast, and obviously Dr. Pulse are doing enough to kind of try to follow that up with that Hellflower, but there's the Grimoire on Fuzi.
The problem really is just the draft from BMG, the strategy, what they need to do is have that high-paced game, snowball, pressure, aggressive, just on top of them,
yep.
Keep going.
Speaking of that, they're going to jump right here to Warbeast, but no, he gets the ulti form off, he's going to be fine. He still doesn't have that Shrunken Head up, but it doesn't matter. He is able to get away, actually, so that was enough of a response there coming out from Reason. And now BMG deciding what to do next. You think they can force a Conqueror here, or is...
It's very, very difficult. This is the problem when you run junglers without minions. When you run into a wall position, like they're really, really far ahead in gold, but with their heroes, it's just very difficult to push towers and just force the fights to happen. And when you're going up against an M4 up Pebbles, as I said, it doesn't really matter when the timing comes. When they have a Dr. Pulsar as well, and they have a Warbeast with the wolves to scout you out,
yeah.
You're just so afraid when you're in the game. You have no idea where they are and where they could be. and you're just slowly kind of losing your grip of the game if you're BMG at this point.
Yeah. So they deny the bottom or the middle tower right there, and they are going to push in the bottom tower. Yeah, they should be able to get this. I don't see a reason Gaming reacting to it. So if they, okay, yeah, they're going to come back in. So yeah, this will be a bottom tower killed again. This is the last outer tower now destroyed in favor of BMG, actually. So the second Arcana just purchased by Dr. Polisir. So obviously he still needs just one more before he has that Hellflower, but still a little bit off. And again, with the pace of his farm this game, he hasn't even really been at that 300 gold per minute mark, let alone 270 that he has right now. So it's going to take a little bit longer, but is on the way for it. It's just a matter of time. But yeah, so the whole Conqueror, are they going to maybe go for it here? There is no vision on the Hellborn side around the Conqueror pit at all. Obviously, they don't necessarily know that, but we do. But there are the Hellhounds that you do have to worry about, and speaking of that, one nearby. But here we go. Into Conqueror, and Reason Gaming, I don't know if they're going to be able to react to this in time, if they even spot it.
Yeah, Silkit has really, really good vision up for doing Conqueror right now. He's controlling the middle lane, he's controlling the bottom lane. Pretty much every path that Reason could choose to go there with, except for the Nofar TP, is covered. But they're gonna give this Conqueror away. This is gonna give BMG a way to get on the high ground, to force that fight that they really, really need to do. Because they're kind of stuck. They're stuck in this place where, well, Reason's gonna split push and we can't really farm.
Yeah.
But we can't really push either. But the token is really gonna enable them to do that. And now suddenly the 15,000 gold and 10,000 experience is going to feel like a really big deal, because suddenly you got BMG ready to take the team fights. They can force it where they want to fight. No, good position for them. Really good to Conqueror kill.
Yeah, you know, kind of curious too when the time's going to be at. What the hell's going on down here? They're fighting around the boat, and Magmus actually ends up getting the kill. That was kind of curious as I go down. All of a sudden, both Hag and Magmus are right, like, on the boat, basically, in that lake off to the side. But in the end, Dr. Pulsar gets picked off, of course, as Parasite and Magma soon enough right there to pick up the kill. But I was
That actually looked ahead. Really weird. I assume you didn't see what happened. Dr. Pulsar actually jumped away and started TPing during his jump.
Okay.
It looked like, and for some reason, the TP got canceled. And he just stood there for like 10 seconds without realizing he wasn't porting anywhere.
Yeah.
Was really weird. So, yeah, that's why he died.
Glitch, maybe, or just simply.
No idea.
It was something else. But, yeah, in the end, he does get picked off. So, that's what really matters. And I was going to say the Wretched Hag is level 14 still, but something tells me try to maybe get at least that level 16 mark, and then that's that motive. Or let's put. Oh, wait. Who?
Wait, what?
Where the hell's the token?
She must have died once.
What? When did she die? Distracted, I guess. You know what it was? Pebbles did have a double damage rune. They must have poured it in on top of her and killed her. Because, yeah, we were distracted about what was happening in the bottom right that didn't even notice that. Okay.
Yeah, top lane.
That's kind of a big deal. But, yeah, the top lane Devourer is actually being turned on right here. He pops a Fairy Rattle. He does have Torture coming, and he's trying to kill Pebbles here. But it's not going to happen. But look at how tanky he is, man. And actually, Dr. Pulsar will get picked off when it's all said and done. He has a hook ready to go. Nymphora will be fine as she's going to pour it out, and that will be the end of that. So, but Devourer, by the way, 14 charges now. He has 2,200 life, including that Barrier Idol and Astrolabe. He is a freaking tanky beast here in this game. Yeah. Doctor doesn't have a buyback. This is actually a huge push chance now.
For sure. I mean, that Devourer is so incredibly tanky to magic damage. And this is looking really good for BMG. They lost the token, but they did get a really important kill, which allows them to go for the high ground. They do have a puzzle box, which is kind of working as their only minions here to tank towers.
Yeah.
Which is fine. But yeah, without the Dr. Pulsar, Reason Gaming's lineup really just not that scary. They don't have enough follow-up. They don't have enough initiation to really get the fight going and really do what they want to do here.
Yeah, you see, they're standing the ground as much as they can. Yeah, Parasite might be in some trouble. There goes the Parasite on Pompto. He's going to be farming out, protecting Melody in the background. Pebbles will stay alive for now. They did get Parasite, but at what cost right here? Pebbles going to end up falling. Warbeast with that shotgun into the background. They get the Golden Torture as well, but now it's wearing off. He has to fall back. Dr. Pulsar is up. The tower barely stays alive, so that will happen at least. And Reason Gaming will ultimately have a little bit of a hold there in the big picture.
I mean, that was a really good fight. I was talking about Fuzi and finding those windows in the team fights, and he really just found the window there. He got really good Bat Blast off right as the Protective Melody went off, like stopped channeling, whatever. And the Magnus ulti was dropped on top of it as well. And as soon as Rhapsody died, everybody started taking a lot of damage.
Yeah.
And he finally finishes up that BKB. He's really close to level 16 now, and suddenly he's a really scary carry. And he's going to be doing a lot of damage in these fights.
So coming up to 31 minutes here in this game. Again, Friesen Gaming just doing enough. It seems like the moral of the story here in this game of just staying alive, if anything. And there most certainly is hope. There really is, especially with Dr. Pulsar again. The Hellflower, it's so close and whatnot. But Gamma Boy, not really is curious to see him struggle. I mean, usually he's one of these carry heroes, players especially, that always, if anything, having a good time. It seems like that's Friesen's strategy a lot of the time is, you know, really make sure to get Imba Boy the farm and kind of work off of that. But this game, obviously, a different story here as far as that spread is concerned.
He did have that. He did have that early farm. He did have the possibility of just farming and getting huge. But he noticed last game how it didn't work out, I feel.
Yeah.
And he adapted, which I think was really, really smart. He's really sacrificed his own farm to make sure the rest of the players on his team.
Bottom lane. Look at DeBauer here. He's going to get the hook. No! Rhapsody was able to dodge, but Magmus actually stuns in. And I think Rhapsody still might be in a lot of trouble right here. She's going to try to dodge in the woods, but it doesn't matter. Now, I will say that was probably best case right there because they were also chasing on top of that War Beast. But he ulted and ran away just before DeBauer could reach next to him and use the ulti onto him. So, again, best case scenario, though, you lose Bandy there. Not the biggest deal in the world. He is going to go Brutalizer next. Well, what is your take on that? Brutalizer on War Beast.
He doesn't really need any more defensive items. So Demonic Breastplate really isn't the highest priority here for him until he really feels like he needs the attack speed.
Yeah.
The negative armor, however, could be a really big deal considering that there's no heroes on the Legion side that has any kind of armor items, and there's not a single agility hero on their team, so no really heavily armor scaling heroes. So negative armor really, really strong this game. But Brutalizer, of course, always amazing against stuff like Magmus, Hag, Parasite even. Just heroes that are so annoying when they just can run away from you. And he wants to be able to hit during his Shrunken Head time. So,
yeah.
No, I like the pickup. I think it's smart.
So, again, you have a level 17 Wretched Hag now. So, she's got that maximum Bat Blast here with that Grimoire power. A lot of AoE damage. You got a level 16 Magmus as well. Sheepstick, I'm guessing, are going to be coming out of multiple heroes here. Both Magmus and Devour. Devour, actually, 3,600 gold saved up with the Blessed Orb. So he's just around the corner, actually, from having that. Finally, a Hellflower finish on Imba Boy here for Dr. Repulsor. And I think the Sheepstick was just purchased by Devour, actually.
Yeah.
And that's going to be delivered
it's
here.
It's on the courier.
Yep. They got their items coming out right here. They're going to make their way to the top lane. They don't have the biggest creep wave push yet.
Yeah, but Pebbles has the deity rune bottled as well. I mean, the Dr. Repulsor, really, the Hellflower is not going to make that big of a difference until he gets the BKB.
Yeah.
That's when you're really going to feel the impact. And Pebbles isn't too far off his BKB either. He does have a buyback for this fight instead, though, which is kind of good. They're going to go for a really deep jump here right up the
Torturer, the Astrolabe coming out. He will eventually be picked off. And now Dr. Pulsar flying around. Here comes Magmus, though, with a big eruption. Dr. Pulsar goes down. Pebbles with that TD. The Courier got picked off, actually. The recipe's on the ground. That's the Sheepstick for Devour. He couldn't get it delivered. He will end up dying, but now Warby's in a lot of trouble. Magmus going to sit on him. Parasite slowing him down. The heal from Nymphora. The Zeal set on top of that. Parasite trying to hold it. Or excuse me, Warby's trying to hold his ground. It's not going to matter, though. Hanske gets the pick off. So the Acolyte staff and the Mana too are kind of just chilling there for now. Again, and they can't be seen by the other team ever since that patch, but that was a really awkward timing. I mean, no doubt they were hoping to wait for at least the Sheepstick to get there. I mean, so Reason Gaming, it's hard to say that worked in the end, but it kind of worked, maybe? They saved the racks.
No, I think they did. I mean, this was a considerably good fight, considering they're 20,000 gold behind, 18,000 experience.
Yeah.
They're fighting really, really well, and it really is the lineup. You can't be fooled by the gold. The lineup really is a big deal.
Yeah.
At this point in the game, pretty much only magic damage on the Legion side. And you look at that Magmus ulti, it looks like it hit everybody.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. But then
Magmus, speaking of Magmus, by the way, he might be in trouble. Yep,
oh, nice
there's
tablet.
The staccato. There's the stalagmites. Can they get him in time? Yes, they can. Yeah, they Nymphora TP down here. But now, actually, will this backfire is the question. Wretched Hag trying to get a ranked. I don't think she's going to be able to, though. Pebbles has the Portakin 1 second. And, yeah, he's going to be able to use it right there. So, oh, it's going to be close, though.
Her blink is half the cooldown of a blink dagger,
that's
though.
That's
so
true.
And he's going to go
cutting
with the staccatos.
Off staccatos. Oh, the wrong direction. No. Pebbles going to be fine for now. Look at that.
Yeah, but is Panny?
Is Panny fine? I think
Fousey?
He might be.
Check that little window in the trees.
Nope.
No. Oh, Panny's gonna use a ward of Rev as a real ward there.
There you go. Well,
it looks like he's gonna get out.
Good support there from Panny, keeping his team alive, and he runs on out right there. There you go.
Yeah.
Dr. Repulsor though, not the same story. Oh, he actually gets his ulti off just in time. And a nice little regenerate for him.
Oh, I think it's such a shame he popped it there. Could have probably even saved it for the next team fight, but chooses to use it. I mean, Regenerant basically works kind of like a BKB for a Dr. Pulsar if he's able to bounce around enough.
Yeah.
There's a lot of AoE that he's going up against, so maybe not. But, yeah, in the end, it's a good, really good pickoff for them on the mag. Slows him down. He probably finishes Sheepstick too, or is really close to doing so.
Well,
that's why he was down there.
You know, speaking of that, I'm having a great time. Okay, so they got the new courier, and there you go. They pick it up finally. They were being very ninja-like with the courier, trying to get it up there for obvious reasons, and sure enough, they finally get it. And now it's going to be delivered to Devourer, so had to be very careful getting those item components there, but in the end he does. And yeah, as you said, Sheepstick on him, Sheepstick on Magma, Sheepstick going to be coming up on Hag. Is that overkill almost? Should Hag be going for maybe something else here?
I don't really know. I think it's fine. I think Sheepstick is like one of those items. It's like stuns on your team. You just simply cannot have too many of
them.
It's just such an overall strong item that I think it's fine. You can't really overdo it. But of course, it wouldn't have hurt to probably see a little bit more physical damage on their team.
Yeah.
They really are very magic heavy, but now they're basically relying on them getting the initiation on the right heroes. They need to jump that War Beast, who actually has, oh my gosh, Shield Breaker as well.
Yeah.
He's going to tear through these heroes without any. They have no armor items at all, so. Sheepstick on Rhapsody.
Here we go. There's, no follow-up, though. That's one of the two Sheepsticks in the background. Pebbles, they jump onto Magmus here. Magmus going to be locked down. Magmus ends up down with a Baron. Couldn't go off time. However, Dr. Pulse also gets picked up. Pebbles now, he's standing his ground, but he is dropping quickly. Warby's trying to do as much damage as possible. He's doing a lot, but is it enough? It doesn't look like it. Wretched Egg blinks away. The random hook attempt there from Jonas the Fan going to completely whiff, but I think the end is going to be near in terms of them falling back from this fight here at least. As, yeah, there's a slow on a Warbeast, and that should be the end of that. There was a buyback. Yeah, Dr. Pulsar used his final buyback right there. Will they be able to get anything out of it? Devourer, he is going to be jumped. He has a Sheepstick, remember. Going to get that off in time. It's being locked down completely. They are going to lock him down long enough for the kill. Beautiful play right there, but Dr. Pulsar does get picked off again. And Regidag Blanket, she's still on the chase now. And Inform now in some trouble. Hugo comes out. There's the ulti form from Warbeast. Again, look at Hag's life. Look at him start to drop. All of a sudden, the crit comes out. And the chase is too long for BMG. They're really getting tunnel visioned here in this fight. And now Hanskin, he's in a little bit of trouble. He does have infested 1 second. Again, he should be fine. And yeah, he is going to be fine in the big picture. But so he ran a little bit too long there. And actually, he really wants to chase. I don't know if he's going to get the kill. I don't know what he's doing, honestly. There's no way he's going to get that kill. Okay, so kind of just toying with him. And that'll be the end of that.
Yeah.
Again, the racks stay alive. I mean, they get big hero kills. It did use their final buyback on Doctor, at least. But
the Warbeast is getting big. That is the problem, really. The Warbeast is getting very, very big. And he's going to start tearing heroes apart. I think the next item for him is probably going to be that Demonic Breastplate. And then even without the ulti form, he's kind of going to be able to man up and just hit heroes. Because there's really nobody he fears. But that initiation was absolutely perfect for Reason Gaming. Magmus is just the one hero they want to jump.
Yeah.
Until they get the BKB finished on Pebbles and Dr. Pulsar, it's going to remain Magmus. That's the priority one hero to kill. And, I mean, there aren't really that much defensive items on BMG to help him. They got the Barrier Idol on Devourer and the Astrolabe, but really not that relevant at this point.
What do you think of the Soul Spore actually on Hanskin? I mean, that goes to the aspect, I guess, of just having the team items they kind of need here.
Yeah, they definitely need the Bulwark. I mean, somebody had to get it at some point, and it looked like D.Va was going for it, but maybe a little bit of miscommunication. I'm not really sure.
Yeah.
But they need it. They're going up against a Shieldbreaker Warbeast, and he's probably going to pick up a Souls next, so the souls of their own to negate that is going to be really, really important.
Yeah. And I would assume he's going to have a defensive for those team fights. Yeah, he has a defensive right now. I saw he had an offensive there as he was maybe going for some kills and whatnot, which is fine. But, yeah, the team fights, definitely keeping that defensive makes the most sense, especially with their makeup and everything. But so, yeah, talk about the right target. They got Magmus. Not only did that prevent his stun and eruption and everything, but in front of his Sheepstick. And then Devourer got locked in long enough. Obviously, Wretched Egg still didn't have the Sheepstick just yet. So, yeah, that was all came together pretty nicely there for Reason Gaming. But Wretched Hack, she is still continuing to farm here, another 2,500 gold saved up, and at this rate, with the kind of the pace of the game right now, you know, very likely have her own Sheepstick even come the next fight. And Warbeast, how long is on the Shrunken Head? 6 seconds now is what the cooldown is. Or not the cooldown, but the duration. Is that, whoa, middle lane, actually, there's a catch on the Doctor and Pulse, so the chain reaction that just missed it. It looked like a hit with the animation, but the ludicrous speed went off just in time. Here we go for Kongra, though. Now, there is a ward of sight at the bottom rune area, so they definitely have some kind of an idea, but there's the Bound Eye. And Tempest is, or Torture even, is going to take care of that. So they know this is happening. The Hellhounds are near. It looks like this one, they're going to look to fight off here. Oh, this quick initiative. Pebbles jumping in the big initiative right there. Tucker, he jumped right into a stun. The Shuriken goes off. The eruption, though, from Magmas coming. A lot of Shuriken hits are off, however, as Torture gets locked in the background. And four big steel stun on top of everything else. But now Parasite, he is chasing. Pebbles half-life currently. Warby's ulti form is going to be wearing off soon. Yeah, Pebbles goes down, and the Hellborn team is like, we cannot fight this anymore. Magmas doesn't have a stun up. It doesn't matter. They get the kill anyways. And now they're going to look to finish off Congor. So, obviously, BMG completely overwhelming in that fight. And now Congor is going to fall.
And it's really, the golden experience is just so heavily in their favor. Teamfight was pretty well executed on Reason, to be honest. Oh, turns to the Congor.
They're trying, but it did not work. And there's a Sheepstick on a Warbeast. That's one of two Sheepsticks. That's going to be a complete lockdown. Warbeast is going to be picked off. And Bad Monkey Gaming on the verge now, especially pulling through. There's no buybacks. That probably is going to do it right there, if anything. Just like that, after all these holes and everything. It's just going to be too much from BMG in the end. It looks like, yeah, they're going to move top, easily clean out the racks, and they'll go from there.
Yeah. I mean, this is game. There's just nothing Reason can do. Zayn played an amazing game. I feel he really big part of why they did so well. And even though Emba Boy is sitting at 113, he played a very, very smart early game that allowed for Zayn to really take off. So
yeah.
The one brother sacrificing his own farm for the other, which is quite noble.
Indeed.
And fun to see. Yeah.
Well. Bad Monkey Gaming again. Yeah, definitely entertaining game at that. Some props to both teams, of course, for putting on a good show. But in the end, Bad Monkey Gaming, just too much in the end. And I think we need to bring back the no more having more than two sheepsticks on a team. That's to be illegal. Totally joking, by the way. I never really got there well in the first place. Anyways, BMG, they do take the series 2-0 over here over Reason Gaming. And, well, that means that sets up an awesome match to take place on Thursday, you know, pending some schedule changes. I'm sure it should all work out and everything, but obviously we'll let you know if that looks to change and whatnot. But it'll be Bad Monkey Gaming versus Stay Green here for this week's title match for King of the Hill. And, hey, you know, what better matchup could we really ask for where we're at? So that's going to be fun. Final thoughts on Sania on this and looking forward?
It was a really fun game to watch, a very different kind of a game to see. BMG running the Suicide Devourer, always fun to watch them play. And actually, wow, I don't know if you noticed this, Hanskin was 17-3 that game.
Jeez.
Yeah, I saw some team fights he just executed beautifully, using his ulti to steal a lot of runes. I saw him steal DD from Pebbles and a Haste rune from somebody else in the next fight. So he obviously played really, really well. But yeah, no, BMG looked really, really strong.
Yeah. Well, there you go. BMG again. They take the series, and they're going to be moving on one more time to be playing Stay Green on Thursday. So, as always, some good matches. So, again, props to both teams for putting on a good show. Reason Gaming falling short, though, yet again. But still a good fight for them, especially not even having their full five-man roster by any means against a team like BMG. So, with that said, that is going to be wrapping things up for today, ladies and gentlemen. As far as, again, the schedule is concerned, Thursday set to be the next day here. For our cast to be coming out for that title fight between Stay Green and BMG. But we'll see. Also, you know, something else may pop up here and there. So if anything, maybe even some scrim casting. Who knows to be going on. Just for some good content and to watch some good heroes and everything. I also do know a lot of streamers out there.